and other people who have a different vision of Lincoln. To back up and to get into some, this book has been attacked pretty harshly in some quarters, praised enthusiastically in others, but I am not, up to this date in late summer, early fall, I've not seen a single review which disagrees with any one of my four major points. The fifth point they disagree with. I've not seen a review anywhere which disagrees with my four or five major points. And if I possible, I can make them. My first point is that the Emancipation Proclamation did not free black people. And it's doubtful if it ever freed anybody anywhere. And that Abraham Lincoln was not the great emancipator or the small emancipator or the medium-sized emancipator. That's the first point.
Can I stop and ask, did you say that, in fact, the Emancipation Proclamation may have created another 500,000 slaves, as I remember?
Right.
How did that
Thank you. Thank you. Not only did it not free anybody, it enslaved or re-enslaved more slaves than it ever freed, because Lincoln said in the document, which most people will never read, he said that he was specifically excluding certain slaves in southern Illinois, southern Louisiana and eastern Virginia and elsewhere, but these were the two main categories. Now, why did he exclude these slaves in Louisiana? Because they were the only slaves he could have freed on January the 1st, 1863. The Union controlled southern Louisiana and New Orleans. The Union controlled eastern Virginia. Now, on January the 1st, he could have freed these slaves. All he had to do was just not specifically exclude them. Instead of freeing them, Abraham Lincoln, unfortunately, on January the 1st, said, I'm not talking about you. This document, you're in the same as you were, as though this document never existed. So we have about 100,000 slaves in southern Illinois, southern Louisiana, sorry about that, and 80,000 or so in eastern Virginia, having some 275,000 slaves in Tennessee who were not touched by it. All across the South, I give an estimate of approximately 500,000 slaves who were re-enslaved or kept in slavery by the Emancipation Proclamation. I want to come back to that, and as I make my second point, and I won't tell you what the critics say in response to this, is the second point is that Abraham Lincoln was a racist. I don't have any joy in making that, but I think truth is important. He who said, who used the N-word habitually, who loved darky jokes and blackface shows, who said in Illinois and elsewhere that he was opposed to black people voting, sitting on juries, intermarrying with white people, and holding office. Two, Lincoln was a racist. Three, Abraham Lincoln wanted to deport black people and create an all-white nation. That's three. Four, Abraham Lincoln was, and this is the controversial point, maybe there were not five, four, that Abraham Lincoln was, contrary to what all the historians say, an equivocating, vacillating leader who prolonged the war, delayed emancipation, and increased the number of casualties. Now, there's no agreement on that. But the other three points, or four points, all my critics agree on. What they say, and I'll be very brief about this, they say, Lerone Bennett said that the Emancipation Proclamation didn't free black people. And he's a terrible man for disturbing the peace of the Republic. That's the first sentence. The second sentence, of course the Emancipation Proclamation didn't free black people. The 13th Amendment, everybody knows that, freed black people. They agree with my first point. The second point, they say Lerone Bennett, this is a review, says that Abraham Lincoln was a racist. And he's a terrible man for saying that. Of course he was a racist. Second sentence. All white people in the 19th century were racist. I disagree with that, and I defend white people in the 19th century. I think it's absurd to say that everybody in the 19th century was a racist, but that's their defense. My point is, They agree with my second point. They say, of course he was a racist. The third point, again, is Lerone Bennett says that Abraham Lincoln wanted to deport black people and create a white nation. Say, of course he wanted to deport black people, not because he disliked them, but because he loved them so much. And he didn't think they'd ever be treated right in America. My point is, in late summer, early fall, is that all of the critics I've seen agree with my basic points. I don't know a reputable historian with a library card anywhere who maintains that the Emancipation Proclamation freed black people. I don't believe one exists anywhere. And yet, people are screaming and hollering, why did you say this? It's the truth.